The Philippine National Police has denied involvement in the alleged abduction of two development workers in Cebu City. Let's now get an update being conducted by the Commission on Human Rights into the incident. We are joined by CHR Central Visayas Director Attorney Arvin Odron. Attorney Odron, thank you so much for joining Dateline Philippines and a good afternoon to you, sir.
May hapon, Ms. Rica. Good afternoon to your viewers.
Thank you, Attorney. Can you give us an update, please, on the CHR's investigation about the abduction of Armand Dahoya and Diane Gumanao, please?
Yes, Rica. We confirmed that the CHR Central Visayas Regional Office conducted a motu proprio investigation and has taken cognizance of the case. Last Saturday, we were informed by Karapatan that there will be an ongoing dialogue between the family members, the friends and co-workers of Ms. Diane and Mr. Armand Dahoya on the one hand and the Police Regional Office on the other hand of PRO7. Of course, I was not able to join because I was not invited in behalf of the CHR. So I just informed Karapatan to update the CHR of the ongoing of the progress of the dialogue. And last Thursday or 2 days ago, the parents of the alleged victim came to the office and formally lodge a complaint in behalf of the victims.
Mm-hmm. Attorney, the PNP has denied involvement in this, but from reports gathered, what they said were the men who abducted the two were identified themselves as police officers. From your investigation, were you able to validate who these persons are? Did you get at least the identity of a few of them?
Well, this is a very serious allegation, Ms. Rica, though, because the family members implicated the law enforcement, no? Precisely the members of the PNP. Mm-hmm. And all we know is that it's the policy of the Philippine government. Of course, we can read that in the 1987 Constitution, it's the policy of the Philippine government to serve and protect the people. Now we have here state actors, the PNP, being implicated. So there is now inconsistency on the policy of the Philippine government and the activities of alleged perpetrators, the PNP, forcibly abducting the victims. Now, again, we have to emphasize that the right to liberty or freedom of movement of all persons is the first recognized human right. No? You have that in the Universal Declaration of Human Rights adopted by the United Nations in 1948. The first human right of a person is that we are all born free, equal in dignity and rights. So let me emphasize about the right to be free. Mm-hmm. Now, any person should not be arbitrarily deprived of his or her liberty. Now, of course, the laws and the human rights principles accepted some exceptions to the rule that a person may be deprived of his or her liberty pursuant to the law if he has or she has committed a crime. Mm-hmm. Now, such as there is impending investigation against him or her for a crime committed, so he may be detained for the meantime. But such deprivation of liberty should only be temporary. Mm-hmm. Temporary in the sense that after the investigation, if he or she is cleared, then he or she will be released. Or if found guilty, he or she will be serving the sentence, maximum of which is 40 years imprisonment. Now, after that, he or she is qualified for parole or executive clemency. So, meaning to say, the deprivation of liberty of a person as a sanction or as a remedy is only temporary.
Mm-hmm. But so if I may cut you on there, attorney, because we only have limited time for the interview, so we have no idea yet if these people were indeed police officials because the PNP denied any hand on this.
Yeah, that is one of the angle that the CHR needs to proceed because the allegation is that the suspected PNP as the perpetrators, no? Four unidentified alleged members of the Philippine National Police. And to be fair with our police officers, now they will be given the days during the conduct of our investigation.
All right. One of the glaring facts on this issue, attorney, is that no commotion was ever reported about this happening on the Cebu port. Togo did not speak. The Cebu port authorities did not say anything. Even the PNP regional police did not raise any alarm that a commotion happened. Why did they keep quiet? Were you able to talk with at least the other authority bodies?
Well, we need to coordinate with the other agencies of the government having control over the area where the incident happened. Now, in fact, we are preparing our correspondents to invite them to for a coordination meeting so we can share whatever evidence or documents we had or object evidence. Anyway, we are serving the interests of the alleged victims here.
Mm-hmm. For the without the cell phone video that went out went viral on social media, attorney, we wouldn't be able to know that there actually was an abduction that happened. Were you able to track down the owner of this cell phone video, and did they give their statement?
Well, it's the PNP that has that originally has the copy of the video. And we are coordinating with the PNP and other agencies of the government if we can also obtain a copy of that so we can scrutinize in the conduct of our independent investigation. Anyway, the CHR can conduct an investigation independent of the other agencies of the government because that is the mandate of the 1987 Constitution. Mm-hmm. But should there be a need to coordinate with the other agencies, then we should not hesitate to call them for assistance. Mm-hmm.
Were there any witnesses that stepped forward to give their own accounts?
For the meantime, no. Even the alleged victims, we talked to the parents to bring the alleged victims because they have their personal knowledge, and that's very important in the conduct of the investigation.
Mm-hmm. Just a couple more
persons.
Go ahead.
Persons and potential witnesses who have personal knowledge of the incident. Mm-hmm. And this is very important in the conduct of the investigation.
Mm-hmm. All right, just a couple more before I let you go, attorney. Would you happen to know who is behind the abduction? I do know that Diane and Armand still up until now hasn't been able to speak with anyone yet.
Yeah, in fact, the parents told us that Diane and Armand are still in the state of trauma. Mm-hmm. They are still recovering from that condition, and we promised to bring to the CHR hopefully next week. Now, in fact, the CHR offered psychosocial intervention to help them recover to recover fast, no, in their experience of that trauma experience last week.
Mm-hmm. Finally, attorney, is there any angle that you're looking at that might be the motive behind their abduction?
Well, initially, based on the allegation of the parents, because they are developmental workers, they engage in street rallies, and allegedly, just recently, the two were subjected to surveillance and tailing by unidentified persons. So probably we focus on our investigation on their being members of progressive groups.
Mm-hmm. All right, and with that, I will let you go, attorney. Thank you so much for your time. We're hoping that there would be more movement in this case, so we're going to be able to at least see what the CHR can do for our alleged victims. Thank you so much, attorney, and you have a good afternoon ahead.
Good afternoon, Ms. Rica, and more power to your program.